really these 2 3 years that led to now were really very important for the AI experts to realize that they needed to understand better the impact of this technology on the real world, on the people and society, and the fact that they couldn't do this by themselves. They needed these experts of other disciplines. They needed the people, the social scientists, and the other people that are, you know, have the skills and the knowledge and the capabilities to understand how a technology can impact the life of everybody. As Wendell said, you know, there are many concerns, you know, short term, he mentioned short term, long term. So, for example, just to give you an example, you know, the main short term concerns. First of all, why do people have these concerns? Well, most people that are not expert in AI, they read about AI, and the way usually AI is depicted in the media is kind of a mysterious technology that can make decision on its own and can wake up one morning and decide to do a strange thing to us and dangerous thing to us. Which in some sense it is like that, but of course not exactly in those terms with the consciousness and but there are, you know, actual concerns that even for people that know the technology and all the methodologies, the techniques, I mean, there are there. And for example, you know, you may know that the technology right now is very heavily based on making sense of large amounts of data, you know, which is something that can be very helpful because our brain is not really able to deal with huge amounts of data and understand what it means, how to find correlations and so on. But on the other hand, it can also be bringing a lot of possible hidden bias in the technology because we don't really understand very well how this system is picking up information and what is hidden in that data. That's the whole point to use machines instead of our brains. So that is one of the short-term concerns. Are we sure that these decisions made by this technology are fair? They are not favoring some, you know, instead of other groups and so on. And another thing is that these techniques are also kind of opaque. So they're kind of a black box. So you have to trust this technology. Otherwise, you're not going to follow whatever recommendations or decision they make. And so having a black box is always something that brings concerns to people. You know, how do I know what is being put into this black box? Who decided to put the decision-making capabilities into the black box? So that's another big concern, that we want the technology to be explainable and the design choices to be transparent. And the whole point is to build trust in the technology, but not trust per se, but justified trust, of course. So they want the technology to be trustworthy, but at the same time, we also want those that produce the technology to be trustworthy. You know, so they have to be clear about how they deal with these huge amounts of data that they collect, all the design choices they make. In some case, in some part of the world, there are already regulations about what the technology can do with the data, like this general data protection regulation in Europe, but that's just in one part of the world, that gives certain rights to the people that are subject to the use of this technology. But in general, that's not true. So the whole point is, you know, is to build this trust in terms of short-term concerns.